One of the most important components of loose leash walking is focus. I want my dog to know where I'm going and what I'm doing at all times. Even if they're not watching me, I want the dog to be aware of my movements. That's why one of the first things I'm gonna do when teaching loose leash walking is teach them how to respond to leash pressure. They feel that pressure and they turn around and check in with me. Another thing I'm gonna do is be unpredictable. I wanna go one way, then go the other way. I want the dog to be surprised by which direction I'm going so that they're forced into a situation where they have to watch me. Another important component is engagement. Not only do I want them focused on me, but I want them ready to interact with me at any given time. That's why one of the things that I'm doing here is when I turn and go in the opposite direction, instead of turning around, I'm actually walking backwards. I'm putting them into a position where now we're engaging with each other. Another important component for me is communication. If you've watched my videos on loose leash walking, both with and without treats, you'll notice that when I turn to go in the opposite direction, I'm saying, this way, come on. I'm giving them that verbal direction. So not only am I teaching them how to respond to leash pressure and focus on what happens when they feel that pressure, but I'm also giving them those verbal cues. I'm giving them two lines of communication so that eventually I can get rid of one of those lines, i.e. the leash. Yes, there are leash laws and I'm gonna have my dog on a leash, but I don't want to need the leash. I want my dog to respond just as well whether I have the leash on or off. And the way that I'm gonna get to this point is by pairing those turns with a verbal cue. So in that situation, now I'm becoming more of a focal point in the dog's world. I am raising my value while we're on the walk. Now in this situation, this is a structured training session. So we're just using a short area. However, when you're on your normal walks, you still want to incorporate these ideas. I know that if you're in a crowded area, you're not gonna be able to give him this much room, obviously. But find areas where it's not as crowded and just practice this before you go into the crowded area or at random intervals where it's not as crowded so that you are, again, maintaining your value as part of this walk. Dogs learn through repetition and association. So the more often that you can practice exercises like this in different places, the quicker your dog is gonna realize that this is not an exercise, this is just how we walk.